Name an artist that you think is overrated.
I don't think I'm really at liberty to do that. I think all of our artists are highly rated. Perhaps in other museums there are overrated artists, but certainly not here.
It really depends on who's doing the rating.
Hi, I'm Liz Diament, and I'm manager of tours and docent programs at the National Gallery of Art.
And I'm Alison Luchs. I'm curator of early European sculpture in the Department of Sculpture and Decorative Arts. And this is Ask the National Gallery Anything.
All right, shall we start? Let's see what questions the public have for us today. Alison, what's a painting that you would hang on your bedroom wall if you could?
There's a little Dirk Bouts Madonna and Child, hardly bigger than a postcard, that I'd love to have on my bedroom wall. It's so tender and it has deep dark blue colors, the Virgin's cloak.
That sounds beautiful, but I'm afraid you can't have it. Ooh, you might know this. What is the largest object in the collection?
Well, actually, it might be one of the Persian rugs that we can't usually put on view because it's very rare that there's a gallery wall that's high enough. Few people know that we have those. But the Widener collection included some absolutely beautiful carpets from what's now Iran and from India. And they are a couple of stories high.
Wow. I wonder what the smallest work of art is in our collection.
Well, I'm thinking of a little silver medal of the Carrara Lord of Padua representing himself as looking like a Roman emperor, which he emphatically didn't. But this little silver medal that would fit in the palm of your hand has a very powerful profile portrait on it. Is there a work in the collection that makes you emotional?
Gosh, there are so many works in the collection that make me emotional, and a range of emotions, I would say. I think one that makes me almost cry is a sculpture, actually. Lehmbruck's Seated Youth, which I think was from 1917, which he made during World War I. And it just is so powerful and intensely sad. And I feel his sorrow when I look at that work. What about you?
Yeah. Well, there's a work in our collection, and this will sound a little strange, but the Poussin Assumption of the Virgin, which you think of, it's a religious concept of the Virgin rising up into heaven. But the way Poussin painted it, you see a woman who's having the way pointed out to her for a reunion with the person she loves best, that she's been separated from for all of her life, and at last she's going to see him again. And you look at that and you think about the feeling and it brings tears to your eyes. Who hasn't been through that? If you could go back in time, what is a work of art that you would introduce to your younger self?
Oh my goodness, that's a really hard question. It's a great question though, isn't it? Well, I think maybe it would be Miro's The Farm, because it was very autobiographical. And I feel like it's all about collecting memories. And so my younger self, I would want to teach myself the importance of collecting memories and collecting people and places that continue to be touchstones for you throughout your life.
Well, actually, my younger self did get to see a lot of works of art here because I grew up in Washington, D.C., and they used to bring my elementary school classes to the National Gallery of Art when I was little. So I saw lots of the works of art, and I was very restless. I didn't get it, and I thought, oh boy, when I grow up, I won't have to come here anymore.
And the rest is history. That's incredible. That's a great story. You? If you didn't work in a museum, what would you do?
Well, I once thought about being a journalist, maybe because I wanted to describe things and tell how things are. And in the end, working in a museum, I get to do that anyway.
I was walking through our sculpture garden this morning, which is so spectacular. And I was thinking about all the beautiful plantings that we have. And I was thinking maybe in another life, I would have been a gardener or a horticulturist and kind of curate a garden. I have no green thumb, so this is highly unlikely.
Thanks for all the questions.
If you have any further questions, please add them in the comments. And please like and subscribe.